It's time to expose the Nginx proxy conf config map and Attila certs secrets to the secure monolith pod at runtime. Examine the secure monolith pod configuration file. This is our first multi-container pod. You'll see that we have the Nginx and monolith containers in here. These containers are deployed in the same pod because they depend on each other. We've talked about the monolith before, so let's focus on Nginx. There are two things interesting to note here. One, we've added a graceful shutdown to the container by adding a lifecycle hook. So on shutdown, we want to run that command. This will allow Nginx to do the right thing, handle all remaining traffic, and shut down cleanly. Two, at the bottom of our pod configuration file, you'll see we added corresponding volumes so that the Nginx container can now access our secrets and configs. Create the secure monolith pod using kubectl. If we examine the secure monolith pod, we'll notice that it has two containers running inside of it now. Now that the secure monolith pod is up and running, we can access it using kubectl port forward command. In a second terminal, let's forward local port 10443 to 443 of the secure monolith pod. Remember, 443 is what our Nginx container is listening on. Use the curl command to test the HTTP endpoint in another terminal. And now we get a response back from the server over the secure HTTPS connection. We can use the kubectl logs command to verify traffic to the Nginx container on the secure monolith pod. The kubectl port forwarding command is great for testing pods directly, but in production, you'll want to expose pods using services.